The kidneys lie on both sides of the spine in the retroperitoneal space between the parietal peritoneum and the posterior abdominal wall, also well protected by muscle, ribs and fat. They are roughly the size of your fist, and the male kidney is typically a bit larger than the female kidney. Now let's see the different parts of kidney and their function. Renal hilum. It is the entry and exit site for structures servicing the kidneys, nerves, vessels, ureters and lymphatics. The medial facing hilla are tucked into the sweeping convex outline of the cortex. Outgoing from the hilum is the renal pelvis, which is formed from the major and minor calyxes in the kidney. The soft muscle in the renal pelvis funnels urine via peristalsis into the ureter. The renal arteries form directly from the descending aorta, whereas the renal veins return cleansed blood directly to the inferior vena cava. The artery, vein, and renal pelvis are arranged in an anterior to posterior order. The kidneys are important to the body's production of urine, but they also play a role in regulating important components of the blood. Blood comes to the kidneys from the abdominal aorta and inferior vena cava, the large arteries and veins that are part of the ascending aorta. Oxygenated blood is brought to the kidneys from a small branch called the renal artery. The kidneys are highly complicated filtration factories. Inside each kidney, the renal artery branches into smaller and smaller parts until they make contact with the core structure of the kidney, the nephrons. The nephrons are tiny coiled tubes of arteries, veins, and ducts. Each kidney has approximately 1 million of them. The nephrons regulate waste, water, and other materials to adjust to the body's changing needs. The renal medulla is the innermost part of the kidney. The renal medulla is split up into a number of sections, known as the renal pyramids. Blood enters into the kidney via the renal artery, which then splits up to form the interlobar arteries. The interlobar arteries each in turn branch into arcuate arteries, which in turn branch to form interlobular arteries, and these finally reach the glomeruli. The renal calli are chambers of the kidney through which urine passes. The minor calli surround the apex of the renal pyramids. Urine formed in the kidney passes through a renal papilla at the apex into the minor calyx. Two or three minor calli converge to form a major calyx, through which urine passes before continuing through the renal pelvis into the ureter. Thank you for watching this video. And also subscribe our channel.